Machine learning, drones, high-throughput phenotyping, and field-based heat chambers are some of the innovative technologies being employed by Australian researchers and breeders who are working together to improve the heat tolerance of wheat.
I think all of us are aware that the climate is changing. It is getting warmer, there's no doubt about it. We're seeing more heat shocks than we used to, so much more variable climate. And I think that's clearly impacting our crops, and we'll continue to do so into the future. And our project has been around finding that diversity for heat tolerance, finding it, accumulating it, and giving it to breeders along with the technologies that they're going to need to select it into commercial cultivars for grain growers.
GRDC has invested in a collaborative program between University of Sydney, Department of Primary Industries and Regional Development, InterGrain and Agriculture Victoria. One of the major trial sites is at the Plant Breeding Institute in Narrabri, where Professor Richard Trethowen and his team are working to improve yield and yield stability in wheat through better heat tolerance.
We've been using a genomic selection approach in our pre-breeding program, and I think that was quite far-sighted of GRDC to fund a program like this. So we've been able to use that technology to combine the genes that we want, but to also estimate those breeding values and recombine in crosses the best materials based on those breeding values. So we've been able to cut the cycle time down. So instead of taking 5 to 6 years to produce a line, we do that in 2 to 3 years now. So it's quite rapid. And I think what we have been able to do is, and I think this is something that a commercial program might struggle with, we've been able to trawl the world looking for diversity.
The main idea within the project is a three-tiered phenotyping approach. So firstly, we bring so many different lines from all over the world, and we look at them in large-scale field trials here in Narrabri, and then we have other smaller sites dotted across Australia. And from the main site here in Narrabri, we use that to train our algorithms and then predict what is going to happen at the other sites across Australia. And so the lines that do really well in those trials end up going into these heat chambers. And so the heat chambers are like bringing the glasshouse to the field. They're a way for us to be able to stress the plants in a true environment, so we get a true result for the growers. And then from there, the ones that do well in these heat chambers, they go into the glasshouse. So we're able to see more in-depth research about physiology and mechanisms behind heat tolerance.
Look, at flowering, it causes significant damage. It's probably one of the most sensitive stages, but it also causes damage throughout the grain filling period. So flowering will affect the total number of grains that are produced, and of course that affects yield. But heat stress during the grain filling period will affect the weight of the grain. And that can lead to screenings and reduced grain weights, lower test weights. And from what we've done, from what we've seen, it looks like we're dealing with quite different genetics. The genetics of tolerance at flowering to high temperature is quite different to the genetics during that grain filling period.
When the trials are so big, so these are thousands and thousands of 6 by 2 metre plots, it's really hard for an operator to go and take measurements individually for each plot, because the environment's constantly changing when you're taking those measurements through the day. So using drones is a fantastic way for us to be able to take a snapshot in time of what is happening within that field. And when it comes to heat tolerance, canopy temperature is really important. So the drones can come across, take that snapshot, and then we can pick out on the image which ones are higher or lower temperature, and then select based on those results. And there's a list of things that we do. So looking at screenings, which is the amount of small seed that we have in the harvested sample, because more small seed means that the type is less tolerant to heat. And then things like 1,000 kernel weight, which is grain size, because both grain weight and grain size are really heavily affected by heat stress at anthesis, at flowering, and at grain filling. So being able to separate those apart and better understand what mechanisms are at play are real key reasons why we use phenology and phenological measurements.
You want to produce a line that has all this diversity in a good agronomic background. makes the breeder's job a whole lot easier to transfer that into a cultivar that has a milling grade that can be commercialised. So that's what we've done. There's still a lot to do. What we've discovered is that there's a lot more diversity out there. There's a lot more we can do to push the game further. We've been able to achieve, I think, a really significant intermediate level of heat tolerance, greater than what we see currently in the commercial sector. But the evidence suggests that we can push that even further.